Friday the 25th of February, and I'm starting with an opening prayer of praise. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above the heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Our readings today are from the letter of James, chapter 5, verses 10 to 12, and Psalm 103, verses 1 to 4, and verses 8 to 13. In March 2020, at the very start of the COVID-19 pandemic, I can remember having a conversation with a senior member of staff in the diocese. No one had any idea how things would work out, and much of our conversation was little more than a stab into the dark. One of the main issues we discussed was the length of the pandemic. I can remember speculating, do you think it'll last 2 or 3 months? To which the reply came, oh no, it's a long haul. How right they were. And the length of it has been so long that the person who I was talking to then has actually retired during the course of the pandemic. During this conversation, it was apparent that our resilience was going to be tested, and it certainly has been tested in all sorts of ways. Today's short passage from James centres around two key words, both of which are to do with the long haul, the words being patience and perseverance. These qualities link together because they do have much in common, but they are also distinctly different. We are aware that St. Paul lists patience as one of the 9 fruits of the Holy Spirit. Given that patience is not a quality which is readily identified with humans, it's reasonable to assume that when we show it, God has his hand in it. In the case of perseverance, I also think that the added element of facing adversity is part of it, and not giving up despite that adversity. At this point, I think it's important to say that we shouldn't think that patience is passive. It isn't, and it would be wrong to give that impression. But I think that the Old Testament prophets provide us with an example of continuing with the task which they have been given by God and not giving up until that task is complete. And in my mind, that's true perseverance, despite the obstacles they faced, which were considerable. And throughout all of that, their focus remained fixed on God. I now come to a prayer linked to healing. Loving Lord, we pray for all who are suffering because of the cruelty of others. We think of those who have no confidence in themselves or in the world. We pray for everyone struggling with relationships, and we remember the lonely. Please be close to all who are rejected or feel betrayed. And we pray for everyone who is in trouble, need or sickness. And we pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. For our prayer points, let's start by picking up on patience and pray that the precious gift of patience is given to us so that we don't act in haste people's lives and livelihoods have been adversely affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, and ask God for strength and courage related to any difficulties we are facing in our lives. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I hope that you enjoyed the rest of today, particularly as the weather is looking that little bit brighter. And our blessing. The glory of the Father, the peace of the Saviour, the power of the Holy Spirit be within you and about you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you today and remain with you always.